Spooky day planned, day in the life, follow us, spooky day. So I'm going to be going out with Elliot to find some pumpkins to carve later on today, and also he wants to look for a Halloween costume, which is exciting. And we're also going to buy food for snacks for later on when we carve the pumpkins. And also I'm going to make a veggie tray. Obviously I'll show you a picture of what that potentially would look like. We might have a variation on that, but yeah, we're gonna try that. And also some spooky drinks. There's one that has like orange on the top, grenadine on the bottom, and you mix a little bit of green food coloring into the orange to make it like a spooky color. And I'm gonna throw like a jelly spider in the bottom of that. So I think that'll be cool. It's like a mocktail sort of thing. But I wanted to show you the sponsor of today's video, again, is the Udi. Thank you so much, the Udi, for working with me again. So appreciated. They reached out to me again and offered to sponsor this video, which I am so excited about. So when they contacted me, what I thought was I would get an Udi for Elliot. So he loves Rick and Morty. He's obsessed with Rick and Morty. So I was looking on the website and they did quite a few Rick and Morty styles. I mean, they've got all sorts of styles. Absolutely amazing. I would highly recommend you go on there and have a look. And it's not just Udis either. It's not just the big thick ones. They do shorts and t-shirt jammer sets. They do t-shirt nightgowns. They do bathrobes. They do all sorts. It's not just the big thick Udis, because I know it's summer at the minute, so we'll probably be wearing these in the winter. But if you want to get on there and have a look at their pajama sets as well, I mean, they've got all sorts on there. But the designs are amazing, absolutely amazing. So it came in this bag, which is great because I'm thinking I'll store the Udis in the bag until winter. Great place to put them. And it always gets me how small they can package them. So this must be like vacuum sealed because it comes like that. It's amazing how small they can look in here. But when you get them out, they're like fantastic. Look at that, Rick and Morty. And it's got the little he loves Pickle Rick on the back there. He's going to be so excited that I've opened this because the day it came, he was like, oh my God, gimme, can I have it? I was like, oh, I'm doing a video, you can't yet. He was like, no, I want it now. So he's going to be very happy. Sorry, I'm holding the scissors up to my hand. He's going to be very, very happy that I've opened it. So let's get it out. Again, if you want to order your own Udi, listen to the air coming out. You can get $35 off with my code JoJo35. $35? $25 off? That's massive. That's huge. Okay. Let's get this baby out. Oh, look at it. They're so soft. They're like really thick, gorgeous, soft material with fluffy gorgeousness inside. You can actually use them as just a blanket, to be honest, as well. Oh, the dog, literally, he wanted to steal my coffee cup one. He lies on it all the time. He absolutely loves it. Look at it. Oh, I love it. Oh, it's even got like the Rick and Morty official design on there. And again, it's got like the big pocket at the front. Gorgeous inside, just really, really nice for the winter. Isn't that gorgeous? I can't wait to give him it. So thank you so much, the Oodie, for sponsoring again, for sponsoring this video. It is so appreciated. I appreciate you so, so much. And again, get yourselves on there, guys. Have a look. See what you can get for $35 off with my code. Why not? Let's get on with today's video. For a walk, and it's absolutely glorious out there, so, so warm. So we're gonna have a little dip in the pool before we do anything today to cool off. So I guess let's go and have a jump in the pool. So I've got my cozy on. Please ignore my tan. My tan's literally in bits. You know when you've got like fake tan that's come off in some places and not others? It's really like bitty, so please ignore my bitty tan. But I'm wearing a swimming costume that I got from Kmart last year, I think it was. And I've only worn it once and I can't remember when I wore it. So I think, actually I might not have worn it, you know. I think this might be the first time, I think. But I love it, absolutely love it. Isn't it gorgeous? Kmart are the best for value for money swimming costumes. It's so, so nice. I'm feeling a little insecure about my body at the minute, and it actually holds me in quite well. So, thumbs up for that. Go and test that water, hey? Let's go and test that water. See what it's like. There's my thongs. Wondered where I'd put them. So the sun kind of, it's in patches this time of the morning. And then as the day goes on, like midday, 1, 2 o'clock, you get like the full sunshine here. And it's lush. Yeah, there's my thongs or flip-flops, as I call them. Let's test the temperature. It's a little, not nippy, not really. Oh, it's quite refreshing, actually. Try not to drop my phone in the pool. The dog loves it out here, don't you, darling? Absolutely love it out here. His favourite spot is just about there. He lies there in the sun, don't you? Yes, you do. Yes, you do. I'd been recording, but Baxter's literally just fallen in the pool. Absolutely hated that, didn't you, darling? So he's just drying himself off. The look of terror on his face. I did scoop him out straight away.
Bless him. What happened? What happened? And he can't get out either. He tries to like climb out, but this is just too high for him. He doesn't realize if he swims down here, he can actually get out on that step and up. We've tried training him, haven't we? Well, me and Elliot did, but he just didn't. He just didn't grasp it. He just couldn't get that if he swam around the corner, he could jump out. So yeah, I just had to scoop him out. Bless him. He'd be fine. Yeah, you can have it now.
He loves it,
don't you? It's over the moon. Thanks to Udi. Love it. Okay. Come on, Bex. What are you doing? It's like, oh, I thought we were going to film.
You know the thing at Zephyr's, the big lights.
These are pirates. What about Superman?
No, it defeats my purpose. Why I want Spider-Man. Looks like I can do it backwards.
Four. Yeah, that's enough. I wonder if you would fit them littler ones.
Yeah, no.
Avengers? Well, it's not.
That is not Avengers.
I know. Christmas section! It's absolutely vast in here. There's another one. Or here. Muscle chest with the face covered. That's a bit better. Spider-Man No Way Home, it's a different one. When we get home,
please look out for small children as they have priority.
Okay.
This is a saltwater
dive. You sure it's going to be dry when I get home?
It changes dramatically.
Oh, you can dry yourself off when you get home, can't you?
Like my sunscreen dried in.
Oh, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, be careful and have fun.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.
Never felt tomorrow closing in this fast. Oh, I guess time's in a rush.
Oops. GC600, some sort of display, I think. I don't know.
Yeah, they do have
Yeah. As we were walking to Woolworths to get the food for tonight, we noticed Daiso had Halloween stuff, and they had the Nightmare Before Christmas, which I've never seen them do before. Absolutely awesome, such cute stuff. So we had to go in, we had to have a look. I just absolutely loved it. In my element. Absolutely in my element. How cute is all this stuff?
It never pays in the end. But still I am here, moving on like before. I'm yearning to.
So I noticed these napkins, Nightmare Before Christmas, and then these plates. So I grabbed a pack of them for tonight for mine and Elliot's little buffet that we're gonna have while we carve pumpkins. I can't wait. It's always a really good night and Elliot really enjoys it. So we're both really looking forward to it. So I thought I would pick a pack of them up. Oh, I saw these earrings as well. I was very tempted. And some key rings. Just all sorts of stuff. Fantastic. Okay, so we made it to Woolies and they didn't have any pumpkins. I was very surprised. They had a big box that had a Halloween thing above it, but in the box was watermelons. So we ended up going to the fruit shop next door. You'll see in the trolley there, we've got a couple of bags. We got a couple of Japanese pumpkins. Now I'll show you them when we get home. They're quite unusual compared to the normal, not what you wouldn't call them normal, but the orangey pumpkins that we normally get. They're quite different. So I'm quite curious as to how well they will carve, but I'll show you them when we get in. I'll do a little bit of a haul of the stuff. Right, so we are back. Like you could see, we spent the day down at Southport and Elliot went on the inflatable thing, but we got groceries while we were there from Woolies. I got these from Daiso. I thought they were so cute. Nightmare Before Christmas plates. I mean, how good are they? And I got a little lollipop and some snakes and the orange juice and grenadine. That was from Dan Murphy's. That's what's going to make the drink. And I also need to get the green food coloring out of the fridge, but I'll do that in a bit. So I got big carrots for the arms of the person picky plate and little ones for his fingers. I thought that would look good. Got some corn chips just for dipping. The nacho sauce is for the little dude. That's for his ribs. And then I got the little tomatoes as well for the joints, and also some, I couldn't remember what they were called, mushrooms for the bottom bit of him. And I just got some strawberries. We've got black olives in the fridge already. I got some green olives. And I thought I could make witchy fingers with these vegetarian hot dogs as well. And a little bit of this for the nail. Let's see how that goes. Got a little bit of cheese, just cause. And some French fancies, because they're lovely. And also we got two pumpkins. Luckily, the fruit shop was doing them because Woolies didn't have any left. And I was gutted, but then the fruit shop was selling them. So we're very, very lucky. They're actually Japanese ones. So they're a little unusual, which I really like. I really, really like them. So let's get started. It's awesome.
It's very big and comfortable.
Love it. They're so comfortable, aren't they? Mm. There's even a pocket for the phone. Love it. Right, let's get cracking. I've got all the stuff for the little veggie dude. So there's that, tomatoes, these. Okay, I need a tray. Well, this looks a bit odd, but I haven't actually got a tray. So I'm going to use this with some greaseproof paper over the top. Okay, let's get cracking with this. Right, so now let's try and make the hot dog fingers. I think I'm going to use the capsicum as fingernails, like I said before. So I'm just going to mic these, put them on a plate, and then see how that turns out. Okay, so I've cooked them, and I'm thinking I might use the pointy ones as like witchy fingers, if that would work. Yeah, I think that would work. So, not cut it too much. Right, does that work? I think that works, that looks great. Oh, I love it. Okay, I'm going to do the rest and then we will stick them on the table with everything else. Cocktails, we've got the snakes, we've got the green food colouring, grenadine, and orange juice. Okay, so is that on the inside or the outside? Anyway, okay, so apparently you put the orange juice in one hand, still can't do it. It's really hard to hold a camera and unscrew things. Right, so I'll open the bag, I'll take the lid off this and that and this, and then we will experiment and see if we can do this mocktail. Right, so I've just put greaseproof paper down just to save the benches because this stuff is lethal, and I'm guessing this stuff is as well. So let's pour the orange juice. So I'm guessing you just go like halfway with the orange. Oops, spilled a bit. And then it says you put a little splash of this in. Okay, right, I am a little nervous about this. Let's hope it trickles and doesn't just pour in. Oh, that's cool. Oh, look at that. Wow. Look at that. That is awesome. I think I've put too much in though. Try and do less in this one. Oh, still too much. Have you seen this, Elliot? Doesn't that look cool?
That's pretty cool.
So I think it's a bit too green. I think I needed to put like a tiny, tiny drop in. However, it looks very spooky. Wow. Actually, I'm gonna leave them like that, you know. I'm gonna put the grenadine in. Wait till all the table's set up, darling. Let's put the grenadine in. It says to literally just kind of squirt it in. So let's see if this works. Can you see it? Yeah, you can. It looks like it's glowing. That is so cool. Let's get a snake. Should we get a red snake? Let's put a red snake on there. There's a red snake coming out of it. That looks amazing, I love it. Isn't that good?
I'm gonna put my snake on it.
You put your snake on.
Ew, I got the worst color in there. Ooh, orange, yes indeed. Oh, they got two heads.
Yeah, they have, the double-headed snakes. That looks awesome. Yours is different. Yours is like, because I didn't put as much food colouring in, I think. Oh, I haven't put grenadine in yours. Duh. That would help, wouldn't it? Mm-hmm. Wow. It looks awesome. Look at that. Both look like proper spooky cocktails.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a vortex.
Like a,
that is like a Rick and Morty thing, isn't it?
It's gone.
It's a Rick and Morty drink.
Yeah, it's his gun. His portal gun.
Wow, okay. I'll take them over to the table. I'm going to take all the food over and then we'll get started and carve our pumpkins and have some food. And we need to put a spooky movie on. Will you find a spooky movie for me? And
Corpse's Bride.
The Corpse's Bride. I'm over the moon with how they have turned out. So good. Love them. Okay, I'm going to do... Excuse the mess. This is ridiculous. But I'm going to put everything on the table and then we'll get started.
Thank you.
can get cracking with the food. Let's tuck in.
I thought this was
real. It turned out so well. I love it. It's very, very spooky. And just a little tea, just for us. How good is that?
Hurricane Torino. More like Hurricane Tortilla.
I don't get these TikTok thingies.
It's not TikTok, it's from Vine.
Okay. Yeah. I don't know what Vine is, but okay. So
wow,
here's the
really
pumpkins. So we'll get stuck into some food and then we'll carve the pumpkins. My goodness. I've really burnt, haven't I? Wow. Well, that's pretty bad, isn't it? I did put sun cream on as well when we were there. Oh dear, never mind. Let's get started. Taste of me mocktail, see what it's like. Just tastes like orange juice. It's nice, tastes like orange juice. Very good, love it, okay.
Is it gonna kill me?
No, it'll be fine. Shall I cut the lid off there?
I'm big, strong, I can do it.
No, I'd rather do it and then you can cut the middle out. Actually, we need the pumpkin carving kits. We'll go and get them.
Victor's got to see his parents, just like he said.
Got more human eyes than pumpkin eyes. I like that. So mine's got his candle in at the moment. Or two candles I put in him. I like him. I'm loving yours. That looks like he's got a nose as well.
Yeah.
That's awesome. I'm just gonna grab some food. And my drink. So here's the finished pumpkins. I think they turned out really well. That one's Elliot's. He's got a mustache. I think that's really good. That's excellent, Elliot. And there's mine. He's got a very, very wide mouth. These pumpkins were great to carve, I think. They look really good. Sets off the movie very, very nicely. Take a photo, actually. Did you enjoy yourself?
Did you wash these? Yeah.
Did you enjoy yourself?
Yes.
It was good, wasn't it?
Yes, very, very.
It was a good day. Okay, I'm going to sign off. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and tune in for the next video. That'll be on Friday because this is going out on Sunday the 30th. So my next video will be on Friday. So I'll see you guys then. Bye!